Satambada Dharmachara, Satamev Jayate. Good afternoon, friends. Welcome to the news desk on income tax, GST and corporate laws. Let's start from the income tax, taxation and other law relaxation and amendment of the certain provision bill 2020 introduced in the Lok Sabha. The Finance Minister Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman has introduced the taxation and other law relaxation and amendment of certain provision bill 2020 in the Lok Sabha. The bill seeks to amend various sections of the Income Tax Act. Some amendment refrain. ITR filing for the assessment year 1920 to be extended from the 30th September to 31st March 2020. Second, ITR filing for the assessment year 2021 is to be extended from the 30th November to 31st March 2021. Filing of the audit report under any provision of the assessment year 2021 is to be extended from the 31st October to 31st March 2021. TDS TCS return for the February and March 20 and quarter 4th of the March 20 as in the case under all subsection are to be extended to 31st March 2021. Furnishing of the certificate under section 192 is to be extended from the 15th August to 31st March 2021. Section 54 to 54GB, the time limit for completion of the compliance is to be extended from the 29th September to the 31st December 2021 for making such completion or compliance is to be extended from the 13th September to 31st March 2021. Other amendment suggested Chapter 6A heading under heading B, the time limit for the completion or compliance is to be extended from 30th July to 31st December 2020. For making such completion or the compliance, the date is extended from the 31st July to 31st March 2021. Vivad Se Vishwas Act. Under this this act, time limit is extended from the 30th December 20 to 31st December 21. For completion or compliance is to be extended from the 31st December 2020 to 31st March 2021. No extension of the payment of the taxes, interest rate for the late payment of the taxes 3-4% per month or part thereof, or only if tax payable is above 1 lakh, and no penalty will be levied and no prosecution shall be a sanction for the delay period for the payment of the taxes. The new provision of the charitable trust for registration, etc., approval under section 1023C and re-registration under section 12A, 12A, 80G is proposed to come in force from the 1st April 2021 from the earlier extended date of the 1st October 2020. Plus, there are other amendments also proposed in the Income Tax Act. These are amendment bill introduced in the Lok Sabha. This is concerning the COVID situations. Second, CBDT guidelines issued 17 September 2020. CBDT lays down criteria on compulsory selection of the ITR for the scrutiny during the financial year 2020-21. The Central Board of the Direct Taxes has laid down guidelines for the compulsory selection of the returns for the scrutiny assessment during the financial year 2020-21. The guidelines has been prepared keeping in view of the faceless assessment scheme and difficulty being faced amid COVID-19 pandemic. So this is very important. We are the separate lecture on the scrutiny grounds of the scrutiny selected for the financial year 2020-21. So please watch that video. We will share link of that video. And third, Mumbai Tribunal Trust handling NPA can't be held as association of the person if there wasn't concerted efforts by beneficiary to earn income jointly. Assessee trust set up by the Asset Reconstruction Company India in pursuance of the SARFAESI Act and RBI guidelines for purpose of liquidating or recovering NPA acquiring from the banks, assessing official had held that the assessee was an association of person and not a trust and brought to tax entire surplus in income and expenditure account. However, it was found that amount realized by bonder not be taxable in its hand as even before money flow to SSE, it was always intended to be passed on only to beneficiary and merely because realization flows to SSE, it would not mean that it was income in hands of the SSE. Further, based on the clause 5 of the trust deed, which entitles contribution to undivided right, title and interest in the trust fund, it was to be held that SSE was a recoverable trust and thus entitled to benefit of section 61 to 63. Furthermore, there being no material on record which would even remotely suggest that there was a concerted efforts by beneficiary to earn income jointly, SSE could not have been treated as an association of persons. Next, Pune Tribunal. CIT exemption couldn't be denied section 80G application due to non-filing of the profit and loss account if accounts of the trust was under preparation. Where a commissioner exemption denied benefit under section 80G to SSE company registered under section 12(8) for reason that SSE failed to produce any evidence about having incurred any expenditure in its financial statement towards charitable object of the company. Since when commissioner exemption rejected SSE application under section 80G profit and loss account of the SSE showing expenditure incurred by SSE on charitable activities was not prepared and same were prepared a little later, matter was to be remanded. Jaipur tribunal, no section 69 addition if SSE had sufficient fund from the past year income for making investment. Where during year SSE had return income of the 2 lakhs approx and purchased agricultural land for 40 lakhs and assessing official noted that agriculture income was and SSE could not prove immediate source of investment in purchase of land and he treated said investment as unexplained. Since income saving of the SSE for the last 4 years, that is the income from the sale of the crop and income from the sale of the vegetables and lashon after deducting agricultural expenses and household expenses could come to approximately 40 lakhs, which was quite sufficient and fully explained source of the investment in land. SSE had fully proved the source of investment in the purchase of the agricultural land and thus addition under section 69A be deleted. Next, Ahmedabad Tribunal, no deduction if employee contribution to the ESI deposited after due date as specified under relevant statute. Where the SSE employer failed to deposit an amount towards employee contribution on account of the ESI with concerned department on or before due date prescribed in law and assessing officer by invoking provision of section 36(1)(5A) read with the section 224(10) made addition of the portion amount to income of the SSE, impact addition made to income of the SSE was justified. Next, judgment in this case, where the assessing officer made disallowance under section 36(1)(3) of the interest expenditure incurred by the SSE, holding that SSE had not furnished any information suggesting that interest-free fund were given to subsidiaries either from its own fund or from borrowed fund, since amount of the capital including reserves available to the SSE was to be presumed to have been utilized in advancing such interest-free advance, thus no disallowance of the interest expenses was to be made on account of the diversion of the fund to extent of own fund available with it, matter was to be demanded. No section 40A subsection 3, disallowance if bank account of the payee was not operational due to attachment order passed by ESI department. In this case, where the SSC had entered into agreement with the company for conversion work on job basis and paid conversion of the charges in cash, as bank account of the said company could not be operated because of order of the attachment passed by ESI department, SSC was entitled to exemption under Rule 6DD in respect of the payment made in cash, and thus no disallowance under Section 48(3) was called for. Second, what is the relevant to be seen as regards Section 40A, subsection 3 is the conduct of the SSC and not the pay. The question could be, did the SSC have a reasonable cause to effect payment in cash? If the SSC has a reasonable explanation, then the proviso under Section 40A(3) would stand attached and the SSC would be entitled to relief. The fact that the payee was identifiable and not a fictitious person would go to show the bona fides of the transactions, and this is the what is required to be considered from the angle of a commercially expedient and prudent business house. Another case, Madras High Court. Madras High Court remanded matter following subsequent rulings of the Supreme Court, as Setcom cannot rectify this order. In this case, where the SSC had not offered income at first instance, but only after search under Section 132, offer additional income and subsequently file settlement application, and settlement commission granted waiver of the interest but subsequently rectified order rejecting waiver of the interest and directed that interest under Section 234B shall be charged up to the date of the order under Section 245D, subsection 4. In view of the decision of and directing that interest under 234 shall be charged up to the date of under Section 245D, subsection 4, in view of the decision of a Supreme Court that settlement commissioner cannot reopen its concluded proceeding by invoking Section 154 so as to levy interest under Section 234B in view of the Section 245I. Subsequent order passed by settlement commissioner based on subsequent legal position on issue was remanded back to settlement commission. Let's cover transfer pricing. Mumbai Tribunal, a company couldn't be selected as comparable merely because it was held as a comparable in the previous year. Comparability of a case has to be considered on year-to-year basis, and therefore merely because a case has been held to be comparable for 1 year cannot per se be considered as comparable for the succeeding year as well. Whether a particular company is comparable or not in an is an exercise which has to be carried out every year in a case of the SSC considering facts of the specific year. Let's cover updates on the GST. AAR Gujarat producer maize bran is classifiable as a bran and not as a cattle feed, taxable at the rate of the 5% GST. Where the applicant is engaged in the manufacture and supply of the maize starch and its derivatives, and during course of the manufacture of the side product, maize bran is produced as a byproduct by corn wet milling. It is held that product maize bran does not warrant classification under Section 102 of the Notification 2 upon 2017 Central Tax Rate, as product does not classify as the cattle feed and correctly classified as the bran under Section 103A and attracted 5% GST. Second, AAR Gujarat accounting or tax services are not in relation to the project undertaken under Article 243G and 243W of the Constitution of the India. No exemption granted. Kerala High Court, not mentioning tax amount in a e-way bill by the transporter is not in a contravention of the GST law, as no separate field in form. Gujarat High Court, in another case, held that the confiscation order passed without giving opportunity of the hearing to the SSC is to be set aside. Gujarat High Court held that where applicant was not given any opportunity of hearing before final order of the confiscation of the goods and conveyance of the applicant came to be the passed, matter was to be remanded back for adjudication afresh. Another ruling, AR Gujarat, manually operated as sprayer pumps are classifiable under tariff item 8224-8100 at tax 12% GST. Another, AR Gujarat product ply as bricks are classifiable under tariff item 6815-9910 taxable at the rate of the 18% GST. CBI issue instruction on the 18th September. In this instruction, CBI has issued instruction to department for no recovery of the interest on the gross tax liability. CBIC has addressed the issue of the interest recovery where administration has been instructed that for the period 1st July 17 to 31st August 20, recovery of the interest shall be made only on the net cash liability. So-called notice that are already been issued to the taxpayer for recovery of the interest on gross tax liability. It will be kept in call book. Another advance authority ruling, Gujarat, a student skill assessment services provided to educational institute are services in relation to conduct of the exam exempt from the GST. Let's cover company law. Supreme Court held in a case that extension of the limitation period on account of the COVID-19 couldn't be applied to a statutory period for condoning delay held by the Supreme Court. And let's cover on the banking. Guwahati High Court petitioner not being a director of the company on date of the commission of the offense, not liable for check dishonoring. There is news on the Hindustan Times. Center allow up to 74% FDI in defense sector under automatic route. Proposed amendment will come very shortly. Thank you so much for watching Income Tax, GST and Corporate Law News Desk. Please share among the professional colleagues or students so that they can get a regular update on the Income Tax, GST and Corporate Law. Thank you so much.